Good afternoon, Word of Life family and friends. I pray you are having a blessed day. I'm sure you are because you know God loves you. That's right. He loves you no matter what. God loves you and you love him back and you have a blessed life in store. I wanted to just take a little time out to share a word break with us. I do these to keep us connected. Keep us connected to the word. Keep us connected even as a body of believers. You know, we have to focus on the right things in this life. There's plenty of negativity out there, and so we need to stay positive. Let's stay focused on the word. I want to encourage you to do a gratitude list. That's right, a gratitude list. I think I mentioned it on Sunday in the sermon, but you know, it's right when you're getting ready to complain about stuff. Man, do a gratitude list. Just start writing down what you are thankful for. And this is actually scriptural. 1 Thessalonians 5:18, it says, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." So this is God's will. God's will for you is for you to be a thankful person, a person that is filled with gratitude. And you know what? It doesn't mean that every situation that you have in your life is going to be perfect. No, because he wants you to give thanks in all things. And so I believe that this is key to bringing about change. So let's say you want things to change. You want something to get better. Then now you start giving God thanks. And it's not that you thank him for bad stuff, but you're thanking him in the midst of anything you're going through. You're thanking him. There's more for you to praise God. There's more for you to thank God about. There's more going right for you in your life than that which is wrong. And the more we focus on the right, then guess what? Those things that are wrong will start to fade away. God will fix those. But if we just meditate on the negative, then that's going to bring more negative into our lives. This scripture here, also 1 Thessalonians 5:18 in the Amplified Classic, it says, "Thank God in everything, no matter what the circumstances may be." That's key right there. We can learn that. This is a person that just has an attitude of gratitude. An attitude of gratitude is imperative because attitude brings latitude. That's what my pastor used to always teach us. You know what? If I have a positive attitude, then guess what? I can expect things to get better. I'm going to rise from these lower places of life. And so thank God in everything, no matter what the circumstances may be. Be thankful and give thanks. See, you could be thankful and give thanks. You ought to give God thanks. And just thank God. You know, we can just, I mean, when I say make a gratitude list, I mean, you could, if you needed to, you can actually pull out some paper and start writing down, "Thank you, Lord, for my salvation. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my health." And you can just go all the way down and you'd find yourself running out of space because there's so many things for you to be thankful for. I mean, for example, if you can breathe without any assistance from any machine or oxygen or anything like that, that is something for you to be thankful for. Because there are some people today who cannot do that. And they have to think about it. So some of us, we take things like breathing and walking, we take those things for granted. But God is saying, be thankful. Be thankful in all things. Don't complain. Don't whine about stuff. Be thankful. I am thankful that God has blessed me. And then this is also good because if you say, no matter what the situation may be, or no matter what the circumstances may be, I'm going to be thankful and give thanks because this is God's will for me, as a Christian. And so I'm going to thank him anyway. And once again, it's not that you're thanking him for things that are wrong in your life. You're finding the positive. You're thanking God because things are always good. It's not as bad as you think it is. And so there's always something there to be thankful for. This also works. Let's say you want a change in your life. Let's say you want a new house. Well, how about you start thanking God for the house you have? Start thanking him. Start thanking him in regards to, "Lord, I like this house. I thank you for this. This is sure a nice house." See, and you're not taking anything for granted. You want a new car? Well, thank God for the car you got. Thank him that, you know what, this car is, I like this car, Lord, it works, and I thank you for providing it for me. See, this positions you to get more from God. But when we complain and when we take things for granted and we start to look at the negative all the time, That's not pleasing God. In fact, that is not God's will for you, because I just read you the scripture where he says, in everything, no matter what the circumstances may be thankful and give thanks. For this is the will of God for you. This is God's will for you. And so let's do these things that are pleasing to God. We'll find ourselves being more filled with joy. Don't let the devil take your joy. Your joy is precious. Your joy is of great value. Don't let the devil steal it. Don't let him take it. You put him in check by praising God and being filled with thanksgiving. And just always be mindful. And once again, if you need to remind yourself, do a gratitude list. Start writing it out. Start thanking God for all the things you have going right and all the ways he's blessed you in your life. I believe God has great things coming for the body of Christ. I believe that he's going to bless us in unconventional ways. I believe he's going to do some things that we've yet to consider. See, just because we don't know how it's going to happen, we just have to know who. We have to know God is working, that God is working for you, he's working for me, and we're going to rejoice together. So continue to stay in that place of thanksgiving. Write out that gratitude list. Make sure that you are aware of all the good that you have going on in your life. And let's rejoice together. Let's be a people that have smiles on our faces. Let's be a people that are rejoicing and worshiping the Lord and not complaining about anything. And God's going to do greater things. He's going to manifest his power. I'm telling you, church, he's going to manifest his power. And so we have to shut the enemy down and say, I'm not going to focus on anything negative. I am too filled with thanksgiving to complain. So let's continue to stay in that place. Let's have that attitude of gratitude, and let's watch God do wonderful things in our lives. I pray that you just continue to stay in the blessing. Be mindful of God's goodness. I look forward to seeing you soon. In Jesus' name.